light, illumination, reflection and manifestation. My dear friends, what you see here is a mirror and the reflection of the Lord. So for you to see the Lord in the mirror, you have to have light. Without light, you will not see any reflection. So there is no manifestation without light. So today the Lord is saying, I am the light of the world. I have come to the world as light. But those who, I am not come to judge, but to save the world. But you don't believe in that light. You are judged by itself. So the Lord is saying, those who believe me, believe my Father. Because we are one. Jesus, those who see Jesus will see the Father. Those who obey Jesus will obey the Father. So Jesus is the exact reflection of the Father. But then we won't be able to see anything without the light of Jesus. So it's important that we have Him with our lives. Whoever believes in me, believes not me, but Him who sent me. And whoever sees me, sees Him who sent me. I have come into the world as light, so that whoever believes in me may not remain in darkness. So in darkness you won't be able to see you, see God, see other, anyone. That's why the Lord is saying, I have come not to condemn the world, but to save the world. To one who rejects me and does not receive my words, already has judged, as a judge. The very words I have spoken will condemn him on the last day. So his word is the light. You see him through his word. In Psalm 119, it is beautifully said, thy word is light unto my path. So in his word, we begin to see things. As in light, as you see you, yourself, and see others, people, God, and everything. So his word will give you that spiritual sight. That's how we find in the first reading, how the whole church was led by the Spirit. The word was spreading and Holy Spirit was moving. There every move, every step, every breath, every decision, every change occurred according to the Holy Spirit. It's beautiful. Meanwhile, the word of God has increasingly and spreading. Barnabas and Saul carried out their missions, and they then came back to Jerusalem, taking with them John also, called Mark. This is how the St. Mark's mission starts. So it's a beautifully spread. On the occasion while they were celebrating the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said to them. So they were celebrating and fasting. So in that fast, flesh is controlled, spirit is moved, awakened. So that's how you open up your eyes of faith. The whole darkened world, the darkness of the world is dispelled with the light of the word. In that fasting, Holy Spirit spoke to them, set apart for me Barnabas and Saul to do the work for which I have called them. See how Holy Spirit became part of their journey, a member of their family. That's why Lord said, I will give you counsel and consoler, paraclete, which means a supporter who will journey with them, who will speak on behalf of them, how he led them. It's beautiful. Rejected, I have come not to, the word says. So, after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. So, they empowered them with the Spirit as a community, empowered them and sent them. And they were going, witnessing to the Lord. they became the light of the world again. Then these men, sent by the Holy Spirit, went down to the port of Seleucia, and from there sailed to Cyprus. Upon their arrival in Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in Jewish synagogue. John was with them as an assistant. So how the Spirit led them. They spread the light, the word, and they were taken by the Holy Spirit. They were guided by the Holy Spirit. So they, Father's mission, Jesus completed. So through Jesus, in connection with the Holy Spirit, we are called to complete that mission until we die. So we reflect, they saw Jesus through Barnabas, through Paul, through Mark. They became other Christ. They reflected the word of God. They reflected the life of Jesus. They reflected the image of Father. So that's what happened when the light comes. To see Jesus, this mirror has to reflect. Mirror has to be clean, clear. Then only you will see Jesus. Like in the same manner, you have to take all the dirt away, sin away, polish yourself in a way that you reflect Jesus in your life. For that, you have to have light. You and the Lord, through light, the world will see the Lord in your life. And you are called to be that reflection of the Lord. Amen. May God bless you.